Although ancient mirrors in general have attracted considerable analytical attention, somewhat surprisingly, Egyptian mirrors have not. In many cases, their composition has simply been assumed, defined only as being made of bronze or as golden in colour. Where analysis has been carried out, there has been a lack of methodological standardisation, and the sampled areas do not always provide representative data. One traditional metal sampling method is a taper section where a wedge is taken from the artefact. However, this method is deemed too destructive by museum conservators as they heavily alter the appearance of the disc. On the other hand, a non-destructive surface analysis such as PEXRF does not provide accurate compositional data for the bulk metal underneath the corrosion, nor does it provide access to valuable microstructural information. In order to combat the issue of gathering representative data while subjecting the disc to as little damage as possible, as part of my master's thesis, a novel minimally destructive sampling and analytical methodology was developed. This was based off of similar techniques applied in coin studies, as a mirror disc could be viewed as a large coin. The sampling approach used flat edge abrasion to expose the bulk metal underneath the corrosion on the edge of the disc, which provides a consistently flat edge. This is compatible with analysis using SEM EDX without having to cut a wedge out of the disc. For SEM EDX analysis, the mirror is placed flat onto a stage and secured in place using nylon bolts. The whole artifact is then placed inside a large SEM chamber and tilted upright in order for the sampled edge to be in view for analysis. This procedure provides both compositional data for the bulk metal and inclusions, as well as microstructural data, just like a taper section. But macroscopically, there is much less damage. The two images you see right now are of the same mirror. However, on the left is a taper section and on the right is flat edge abrasion. The metal in the image on the right is more corroded than the left, as the taper section was collected in the 90s, whereas the mirror was sampled via flat edge abrasion last year. As you can see, there is little difference in terms of how the sample looks under SEM. The EDX software also allows elemental maps to be created that show the distribution of elements, which can enable the identification of any possible surface enrichment present. As high-resolution grayscale images can be captured, a map can be created for the exposed surface to match the elemental map. From this, inclusions as well as surface enrichment can also be identified. Additionally, once a specimen has been etched, another map can be created showing the microstructure of the entire sampled area. The information I have gathered so far from archaeological specimens using this experimental methodology has enabled me to reconstruct the mode of manufacture. The mirrors were cast into a mould, roughly the shape wanted, then were subjected to repeated cycles of hammering and annealing before being polished. This was done to increase the hardness of the metal, which would have provided a better reflection. Also from my work, it is possible to say that ancient Egyptian mirrors were not exclusively made of bronze, like previously stated, but arsenical coppers also. Some of the mirrors have very high arsenic content, up to 8 weight percent in the bulk, or an arsenic-enriched surface around 30 weight percent, which means they would have been silvery in appearance rather than golden. As part of ongoing research, the information gathered from archaeological specimens using this method of sampling analysis will be used to experimentally recreate mirrors. Coin-sized blanks based off of the range of compositions seen in mirrors will be produced and then work the same way the discs were. This will allow for the collection of data regarding differences in colour and quality of reflection between a variety of compositions and hardness. As most mirrors are now corroded, meaning they are green or black in colour, this kind of experimental data can be directly applied to the archaeological specimens, essentially allowing the recreation of the original functionality and condition.